celebrate life's little defeats. I think I saw that in a poster in the break room.
Well, we've got the best workplace ever, packed with motivated contestants eager to get down to business.
In round one, there are 5 obstacles, all unique and challenging, not to mention hilarious and amusing. The banana hammocks are a series of low, wide swings set in the mud that are shaped like, well, you guessed it, bananas. Easy, right?
Nope. They also have slippery surfaces so that they slide whenever the player stands on them.
Plank in the face and double diving boards combine 2 of our easier obstacles into 1 very challenging one.
I don't know, it just sounds sketchy. Planks, diving, things in the face.
Well, trying for the contestants, nothing but fun for us. The high-low big balls make the big balls even more daunting by adding a little extra wrinkle.
Yeah, these big balls just don't sit there. They move up and down as well. And boy, does that dice things up.
This challenging obstacle combines the fence flapper with everybody's favorite giant hammer, the doorknob.
And an odder, more hilarious couple hasn't been seen since Felix and Oscar.
Here's another one of our dastardly creations.
Put together the rug pull and the rolling stones, and what do you have?
What I said, a dastardly creation.
Meet Party Queen, who wants to win so she can drop out of the rat race and party all the time.
Banana Hammocks, no match here.
Say hello to whatever, dude. A surfer who dreams of moving to Tahiti and surfing every day of his life.
For all of us when I say, ouch.
And here's Cannonball, a man with an odd fashion sense and unique dreams, like opening a pet resort. Don't ask me, I just work here.
Beware the mud.
Oh, and he looks so confident too.
Meet Human Carpet, a wrestler who won't let anyone walk all over him.
You know, if you looked up athletic in the dictionary, you wouldn't see this guy.
She's been storing potential energy for that wipeout for quite some time. Or, no, I'm not sure.
Hardly. I hate to see a perky woman like that wipe out.
For yourself, I love it. Oh, nothing bizarre about that wipe out.
No, but a lot's bizarre about him.
Like an Olympic diver.
Definitely going for the gold, Johnny.
Not a hoops girl, huh? smack. Balance and timing. Everybody faces the dreaded sweeper.
Yeah, bad for them, good for us.
The gyro sweeper is even more challenging than the sweeper because the mechanical arm rises and falls.
And the contestants must make a split-second decision to either jump it or duck down and let the arm sweep past.
Woman like that wipe out.
Speak for yourself, I love it. Your thing goes boom.
And a mighty one it was. In round three, it's a free-for-all.
Yeah, just like my family reunions.
Unclaimed baggage is a giant spinner with two walls of large punching bags.
The sweeper arm tries to knock players loose as they struggle to be the last one standing.
And those who finish first have the added bonus of being able to hurl bags at their competitors. Good times.
Say, I'm closing my eyes. Tell me what it's over.
Can I see your baggage claim ticket, please? Ah, the big guy.
Samurai delivers another epic wipeout.
Ooh, nice wipeout.
Nice for us, for the contestant, not as much, really. You know, if you looked up athletic in the dictionary, you wouldn't see this guy. Taken down by the baggage claim. You wouldn't see.
Oh, nothing bizarre about that wipeout.
No, but a lot's bizarre about him. You know, if laughing at a wipeout is wrong, I don't want to be right.
You gotta fight for your right to laugh at a wipeout. Unclaimed baggage claims another thing. This thing goes boom,
and a mighty one it was. I say, ouch. At the conclusion of round three, this is how things stand. The wait is over. We finally reached the wipeout zone.
And a big bag of cash awaits the winner.
The first obstacle in the wipeout zone is the catapult.
Not much strategy here, folks. Just sit back and enjoy the flight.
It's nonstop, with plenty of in-flight entertainment, at least for us. In this version of the barrel run, the player runs up the ramp as before, but after negotiating one ramp, another ramp awaits.
More treacherous for the player, more humorous for us.
In this version of Gears of Doom, we ratchet things up and add one more gear, bringing the total to four.
Gears, ratchets, what a bunch of tools.
You got that right. This scary-go-round has some added challenges.
Yeah, we've added a collection of hanging balls and blocks above the extra sweeping arm.
Gives me chills just thinking about it. The pistons and blades are gonna really fly in this round.
Yeah, more blades, more pistons, and they are moving a heck of a lot faster this time.
This edition of the launch pads features more trampoline, each higher than the one before.
Look at it as an opportunity to take your game to the next level. Get a jump!
Not much to get, partner. Not much at all. Cinderella tale.
I love that story.
Scary go round for a reason. She has plenty of moxie. I'm sorry, did you just say moxie? Nothing comes easy in the total wipeout zone. And no one knows that better than this guy right now. On the launch pad. Nice, strong finish. Looks like she's been storing potential energy for that wipeout for quite some time.
to be. Woo-hoo!